I said, I don't really know what.
Welcome, 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 welcome into the Set Your Line Up podcast. This is episode 10. We are in the double digits. Episode 10 of the Set Your Line Up podcast.
All right.
Listen,
subscribe, go follow the Facebook page, Set Your Line Up. Subscribe, share, like, comment. There's a lot of good comment been going on. A lot of you. It's good to know that a lot of people that follow this show do know sports. To my right, I got who?
This the one and only Trigger Man Joe, the brother you love to hate, the brother that get it done, the brother that pay his bills on time. Not throwing no stones, but I just thought I'd put that out in the atmosphere. All the brothers out there on the podcast and people who listen to the podcast, pay your bills on time.
Man, who owed Joe? to the south of us, coming from the Sunshine State, I got who?
Sunshine State?
Below Joe?
Is this your boy.
Too much ginger ale, man.
This your boy, Clutch, a.k.a. Domino. And believe me, I'm the first, just like Obama.
To do what?
That's a bar.
The first what?
No bar. That sound like a cry for help.
You the first what, man?
I thought you were about to say the first president to smoke cigarettes.
The first.
Oh, he's just
the first. I'm just the first domino, baby.
Up under me, I got who? Pause. No, wait. To the right here, to the square down there. I got who?
Hey, right here. Hey, we got unpredictable, like I always say. I said what I was going to say anyway. I'm unpredictable. Now, shout out to my boy, Root. Hey, Facebook police, free my boy, Root. He's trying to get back out there, man. He's trying to post. You can't ban my boy, Root. He the one that don't like Fred. All right?
I am Root.
So shout out to my boy. Shout out to Root. This for you.
He don't like nobody.
Shout out to Root, man. He hit me up. He said, hey, man, I'm in Facebook jail, but, you know, I want to get back in your league. So I don't think he would trade. I don't think he did much in the league. But maybe he didn't.
Hey, he did about as much as Bronny James like, doing the games.
Oh
boy. He did about as much winner.
As Bronny James doing real basketball games.
Man, Bronny James would beat you by 30 going 21.
No, he wouldn't. Because the first time he go up and dunk, he could be on the ground. Now he got to make a business decision. Beat me or lose your career.
we ain't going to hold y'all long this week. We gonna get to what we came to do. I hope everybody had a good week since last week. Next week is Memorial Day
weekend.
I think so. We might. I don't know. We'll talk. We have to.
Yeah.
We might make some shake during the week or something. I don't know. But this week, episode 10 of Such a Lineup podcast, we'll talk about first the NFL schedule release. And nobody does it like the NFL. The NFL makes the things that the NFL controls the calendar. They control. They really control January, Super Bowl, February. They find a way to control March and then April with the combine things and April May with the draft and it continue, man. To make a big thing. It was a lot of exciting. Did y'all see any of the teams do their their personalized draft, I mean, schedule release?
Yeah.
I glanced at it, but I didn't pay too much attention to it. If it ain't still the news, you know, it really ain't news.
Did I see the Steelers? No, I seen the Browns and the Ravens. But I did see the New Orleans Saints personalized. It was boring.
Who
boring.
That?
It's boring. But then at the end, the schedule dropped. And I'm looking for my Falcons on the Saints schedule. And I'm looking. I see every team. And then on two lines, I saw something that wasn't a team.
And that's the Falcons.
And one line said, bless their heart. And the other line said, they not like us. So I was very upset, but I was very entertained. I was very much entertained.
What's that's up? How we do it in the Bayou.
Yeah.
Hey.
Y'all, go ahead.
Man, listen. The schedule, you know, we the Falcons are who they are. All right. Sometimes you could be the first, but it's not a good first, right? Like right now, we want to know who was the first black person to renege in spades and get caught, right? We don't know.
All right? Siri don't know? We can't ask Siri?
I'm going to have to find that out. Again, who was the first black person to run off on a plug twice? Some things it's just a given, right?
We'll never know.
So when we look at the Falcons, yeah, we ran an extra score to score a touchdown at the last minute. You know why? Because we treat them like Aretha Franklin be asking for R-E-S-P-E-C-T, and we have none for them. Anybody else, we would have nailed down. But you know what old Jameis Winston and they said? Man, it's the Dirty Birds. Let's make sure we put them to bed. That's what you do. When you got an enemy, it's like the movies. When you watch Scream and Jason, know what they always say? The fatal flaw. You never cut off the head. And that's what we was doing, cutting the head off the snake. Y'all are done. Y'all so done. Y'all didn't drop the three quarterbacks. Don't even know what the hell going on.
Are you getting makeup done before the show, man?
This is my natural beauty skin.
Oh, okay, natural beauty. I was saying because I didn't put that in the budget. But, okay. Clutch, I don't want you to fall asleep on me. Clutch, what you think? Did you see any of the schedule release? No.
Yeah, I saw the schedule release.
Oh, did you see one of the most
question like that?
Oh, hey, I don't know. You could have been on Mars or something, man. You could. Listen,
like a robot right now? Because Gino, you sound like a robot right now.
No, you inside, Clutch. I mean, inside, Clutch. You know,
Sound good, but you sound like Angry Man.
Yeah. Me?
Nah, Clutch.
Oh yeah, what's wrong with him?
No, what? I didn't hear Gino's question because he sounded like he underwater.
I sound like I'm underwater.
What was your question, Gino?
Speaking Morse code.
I said, did you see the Cowboys schedule?
Of course I did.
Why are you looking for it?
I'm just looking forward to playing the Steelers and the
you ain't looking forward to that.
Everybody,
I want the Steelers and the Ravens. The Saints don't matter.
They said the same thing about Jerry Jones.
Who that?
That's what we saying. Who's that?
The Cowboys have one of the best videos of Jerry Jones and people FaceTiming.
They got enough money.
And we just going to spank Cleveland first game. I mean, I don't even know what – we shouldn't even show up.
Breaking news, Deshaun Watson got his hoes back.
Mm-hmm.
Might go on a Super Bowl run, just saying.
No, did
he? He got him in different area codes.
So, we got some prime time games with this this schedule. The NFL, like I said, the NFL makes what they're doing important. And they made the schedule release. It's getting more important every year. And let's talk about the primetime appearances. We have three teams with six primetime appearances. That means Sunday Night Football, Monday Night Football, Thursday Night Football, primetime. We got three teams. Anybody know what three teams?
For opening
the Chiefs?
No.
The Chiefs?
The prime time, the most prime time games. Those are Thursday night.
The Jets got more than everybody.
No, the Jets got six. It's two more teams with.
It's not the Chiefs.
Cowboys one of them.
No, the Chiefs have five.
The Jets had more than anybody.
The clutch says the Cowboys. Yeah, the Cowboys had six, and one more team. It ain't the Chiefs. It's the Chiefs.
Buffalo Bills.
Nah, the whipping boy of the Chiefs.
Is it the Ravens? Is it the Ravens?
No, the 49ers. Those three teams have six. You got the Rams, the Chiefs, the Bengals, the Packers, Lions, Eagles, Ravens, Dolphins, Bills. All those have five. I thought the Jets had
like nine, and with the one overseas too. But I don't know. Like I heard that. But my hearing ain't as good.
But it seems like those. All right, here are the teams with prime time with five or more. You got Bills, Dolphins, Ravens, Eagles. That makes sense. Lions, Packers, Bengals, Chiefs. That makes sense. Rams, Cowboys, and the 49ers. That makes sense. The Jets having the same or maybe more if we check deeper. Pause. Do the Jets should have them in the primetime game?
Yes.
Why?
I say yes. Because they got a bad man, Aaron Rodgers.
They had the bad man last year.
Only last night.
The first game. Players. Come on, man.
I think so.
What if he don't make it this year and we sitting there stuck looking at them?
Hopefully they got a better backup quarterback than what they had last year.
We know who got good backup quarterbacks.
Uh-huh. But, you know, the NFL everything is better and magnified when you're playing in New York, you know. One of the biggest markets in the world. So, look what the Knicks are bringing to the NBA right now. So, everything is good when your teams from the biggest market cities are doing very, very well. So, they're predicting the Jets to be a home run with Aaron Rodgers, who won two MVPs over the last 4 or 5 years or whatever it is and stuff. So, they expect him to get back to MVP form, AR-15, AR-12.
It should be AARP-12.
Okay. Clutch and Clutch and DSPN, they teams are spoken for in prime time with the Ravens and the Cowboys having five. So let's go to four. Four, we got the Texans, the Steelers, the Buccaneers, the Seahawks, the Falcons, the Browns at four. So there go another two teams. Trigger Man Joe with the Steelers. His team have four prime time. My team, the Atlanta Falcons, having four prime time. But
there's a difference between the two.
Yeah, it's going to be a difference.
I think the Texans
should
have six.
Man, we ain't worried about y'all. Lightweight, man. Light work.
I do think the Texans Clutch said he thinks the Texans should have six primetime games. I do think they should be the only team in Texas with six primetime games. You are correct, sir.
Now, I disagree.
They should take the Cowboys out and put the Texans in. You are correct, Mr. Clutch.
Hey, I heard
the Falcons. No, I ain't gonna see it. Okay. This is a PG show. I ain't gonna see it.
Hey, I want to say this, Gino.
PG.
DJ DLN boy, I agree with the schedule because if you notice, the Saints are not on there. You know why? I think the teams, except for one of them, they should have the most primetime games because guess what? Everybody loves a clown show on television. That's what you're supposed to do, right? You know what the number one reality show was? Atlanta Housewives. They like to see people act a fool. So guess what? That's what we want to see. We don't want to see civilized thing. When you go to, but here's the thing: when you go to the Oscars, Friday don't make the Oscars. It's always the Titanic, and that's where we are because we're about to sink ships. And here's the thing: because we're so fortunate and blessed in New Orleans, we got the second weakest schedule in the NFL. Bless you. We don't want to be on prime time. We want to be under the radar, and we want to watch the clown show. We got Jerry's World. We know that sounds like a circus. You don't have a quarterback. He don't know if he's coming back. The man don't know if he got a contract or a headline. I don't know which one is worse. Jeez. You got rid of Zeke to bring him back to do the same thing. The backup, the running back that backed him up, that started, he gone. You got one of the best receivers in the league. You still don't want to resign him. You lost two of your linemen. Man, listen. Let me say this about Dak Prescott. This is why I know the Cowboys are a clown show. Are there quarterbacks in the league better than Dak? Of course. But let me ask you this question. The ones that are better than Dak, what are your chances of getting them? That's what I'm trying to figure out. You're trying to hope. The only quarterback, hey, I can tell you now, they got two quarterbacks that's hot garbage, and they both reside in Atlanta. Hot and garbage. Combined, they have two quarterbacks, and combined for 0.75 of a quarterback. Y'all, so what I'm trying to say is, the Cowboys, I agree with Stephen A. Smith. They are an accident waiting to happen. You lost to Aaron Rodgers backup in the playoffs by 30. I'm through with the Cowboys. I'm getting tired of seeing them on TV. You know what I do when I'm depressed and I want to cheer myself up? I watch a Cowboys game because I know it's going to be entertaining.
You want to know what I do when I want to cheer myself up? I turn my camera to the side so it look like everybody else in the box. That's what I do. That's what I do.
That's what's up.
Listen, you want me to tell you why the Saints don't have any prime time games on TV?
Tell them, Doc.
Inform us. Enlighten us.
Because Ricky Williams. He blame everything else on Ricky Williams, so it's Ricky Williams.
You're damn right. His fault, too. He's smoking marijuana before it's legal.
I think it's because y'all got a trash stadium.
They got a nice stadium, though.
Well, they got a new one.
Mercedes-Benz?
No, we are Mercedes-Benz. They like Little Caesars or something.
But it's nice. I've been to it.
The Superdome?
It ain't the Superdome no more.
Yes, it is. What is the same building, man.
No, it's not.
It is. Hey. The Saints?
It ain't the Superdome. Sims, you don't know what
it is? Please don't say nothing in the comments, y'all. It's
the same building. They just upgraded. But see, here's the thing. What they don't understand. There's some things that you don't have to change. We still got the same White House from the 17th century. We still got the Empire State Building. We still got the Empire Building, whatever. You still got Disney World. Some things don't change. It's a classic. You don't have to change
it. Money funny over there, man. Your money funny.
Nuh-uh. The money is right because guess what? We got enough sense not to charge New Orleans people for extra taxes to put a stadium that you just built 10 years ago to go back and make a new one.
Well, hey, that's why
AK broke.
Atlanta got money just spitting it out, man. Hey, we want a new. We took Mercedes-Benz from y'all.
Y'all can have it. You know why? After that warranty run out, that Mercedes-Benz ain't worth nothing.
Can y'all?
So it was Mercedes-Benz at one time, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know we didn't want the name no more, so we passed it on to our little brother.
We took the name.
Why you want the name of your opponent, your division rival? We took that sponsor.
Oh. Shout out to the other show named Set the Line Up. Y'all got a sponsor, we'll come take that.
Take it then. But real talk, the NFL, I think we are in line for one of the most exciting seasons in the last 10 years. Just the launch of the NFL schedule, you know, I haven't heard this much buzz since Kendrick gave Lamar a schedule ass-whooping. The 49ers, speaking of schedules, they're going to play four teams coming off a bye. The Steelers, the second half of the season has the most difficult schedule probably in the history of football, but it's okay. We never had a losing season under Mike Tomlin, and we ain't finna start having a losing season right now. So we just gonna line up against the people we're supposed to play in, do what we do best, win. But we got to win in the playoff, because if we don't win in the playoff, it really don't mean a thing if you don't have a chance to get in the ring.
They're going to stay mediocre, right?
So if we're mediocre, yeah. what makes it a lineup?
The Steelers will be okay until the Cowboys come in time.
Y'all are the cockroaches of the ocean.
No. September 8th by 4 o'clock, the Steelers are going to be 0-1.
We're
going
to take over the city, and then we're going to take over the game.
We'll see.
Y'all might take over the stadium. Take over the game, and we slapping people and taking names. We taking hats too, Atlanta Falcon hats. You got inside the paraphernalia. We taking it and walking around taking their stuff.
I'm gonna stomp a towel. I'm gonna stomp one of the yellow towels. Listen, we are excited. See, the NFL got us excited about us excitable. Yeah, that's the week I heard.
Hey, excited. You know what I like about the NFL? All jokes aside, and I think that when we talk about the NBA, I think the NFL knows how to get it right. And I think sometimes we get misled because, for the most part, the NFL is North America. The NBA is global because they're taking players from, you know, from Greece and things like that. So those countries are going to tune in. But with all the money that they got around the world that the NBA is generating from other countries, NFL is still making more money than the NBA. And I think part of the reason why is this. And I think all of us play football to some level, high school, a little college, whatever. But I think in the concept, I don't know about you, Gino, it depends on what part you came in, but we were taught to play through pain. Sometimes you have a job to do, and because I think these new generation don't understand you have to take pride in your job because that's how you start to move up. See, this generation, they got a $15 a $15 work ethic, but they want $1 million same with their work. And the reason why I say that is when I look at LeBron James, the difference between the NFL and NBA, I did the research. LeBron James has missed 35% of the games since he's been with the Lakers. When he's playing, they're winning 65% of the time. When he's not playing, they're winning 17% of the time. Now, when you start to get to the first round, you got to play a Denver instead of being one of the top seeds, and you get to play New Orleans Pelicans. And you got a, you know, pretty much an easier chance to win a series. They're folding. And so the NFL, when I look at Patrick Mahomes, his knee was hurt in the playoffs. He was like, I'd be damned if I sit down. When I look at some of these players, they are playing because it means so much to them. And they understand that every play counts. Every game counts. In the NBA, you start to lose people because you don't know how to network. Because the first game of the year, the Chiefs and Ravens couldn't be any better. You could put the Cowboys in there. That's must-see TV. I'm going to respect the Cowboys. No joking, right? But then you look at the NBA, you can say, well, then we're going to play Boston first game. It sounds good, but we don't even know who going to play. So how interesting is it? The NFL are geniuses. They understand they're going to make them work for their money, which I should. Sometimes I think certain things should be guaranteed as long as that player's, you know, out there being able to perform, but they just know how to market.
I agree with that. To piggyback on what you're saying, that's why the NFL is the king. The commissioner of the NFL, he almost makes $65 million a year. And I think in 2022, the NFL generated a total of $18.6 billion in revenue. Let me say that again, $18.6 million in revenue. Almost double what the NBA makes. I think they make roughly $10.2 billion. So NFL is king of the swing. They're not afraid to make changes. If they make one rule change this year, they'll go back and revisit it the next year, looking for perfection to give us a great product. And they try to take over the world. Look how many other countries they're trying to bring the NFL to. So how can you go wrong with the NFL?
Speaking of that,
Go ahead. 100%. No, I'm just saying I agree with Trigger Man 100% because, like I said, with the NBA, these guys are able to sit out a certain amount of games a year. That's bull crap. You know, that's why they're not making the money because, you know, when people come to see LeBron and he's not playing, you know, it's just a travesty that the NBA is allowing this kind of stuff to go on still.
And one more point. Go ahead,
the more games you add to the NFL, that's going to be 18. 18 games, I think the more games you add, the more games people will sit out or play less in a game. And the only reason the players, the NBA players, if they changed it, the only reason the NBA players sit out games instead of play to the third quarter and sit out is because their stats. If they put up 12 points and play the halftime, that affects their per game stats. So they just sit the whole game out.
But the '90s 2000 wasn't like that though.
The what?
Nope.
The '90s. Jordan played 82 game seasons. He played more 82 game seasons than Kobe, LeBron, and somebody else named all combined.
Yeah, they weren't getting paid like that.
That last three-peat, he was getting like $30 million a season, wasn't he?
No, I was in,
go back and look at it. It's in the $25-30 million range.
I was in sixth grade, but
Jordan, man, king of the swing. What grade you was in?
I don't know, sixth, seventh grade, eighth grade. I don't know. Listen,
but like when we with the NFL, play other fantasy sports. We play baseball, we play basketball. It's solid. It's okay, whatever. But when we play the NFL fantasy, we can't get enough of it. And then once it ends, we can't wait for the next year to start. We're craving. And like you said, the NFL dominates the headlines. So they always keep us in the loop and keep us engaged on what's going on. And we just want more and more of this product, of this engine that's called the NFL, because it's the best thing that ever happened. Woo! Ric Flair.
Hey, since my son wanted to mix basketball and football, y'all tell me this can y'all recognize this sound right here? Hold on.
You get a better audio, man.
Hey, yeah, man.
Shout out to D. He was supposed to be an audio man, but he said he worked.
That wasn't nothing wrong. That was just out of the whim. I thought to add that.
D ain't got no damn job.
Boy, you like time in for Martin, man.
What sound was that? Hey, let's stay on track.
That one CVS?
Who? CVS. Plan B.
That's TNT.
I wish CVS was open that night. Sims.
That's TNT.
Plan B went out then.
That's TNT. Y'all, I know that.
Yeah, it surely wasn't. For $44, I'd have had a lot of them. Mm-mm.
Y'all joking? Y'all trying to be funny? We're going to be funny today?
Hey, man.
You talking to a man? You talking to a man that over the years, I calculated $258,000 in child support.
The Pacers are shooting 76% at halftime.
That's what I was doing with kids when I was producing, getting them at a 76% rate.
One shot, one kill. I hear you. Unpredictable. AKA.
I had one shot, two kills. I couldn't figure that part out either. Shout out to the Sims clan. They'll be here this weekend eating all my food. That's what they do. They gang up on me and try to get money. Now I got a fifth one.
Yeah, okay.
That was NBC Sports, man. NBC Sports.
Okay, see, Ray and Claude wanted to play today.
But that boy said it was TNT. I'm like, what?
Ray and Claude wanted to play today. Ain't that right?
Ray and Claude
is. Hey, I look like Ray and Claude.
I don't even know who Ray and Claude is. You got to put me up on game. I got to Google it.
Of Life.
Ray Life, the movie Life.
Who a Red Claw on World of Life?
You and your partner over there talking about CBS and TNT. Listen, NBA.
I was joking.
No, Jangle. Listen, NBA on NBC. That just hearing that song right there brought back so many memories and great days. The 90s was like the best decade ever. Ever. And everything.
We done with the 90s.
No, we will. NBC has landed an NBA contract. And Some say that means bye bye to TNT.
Yeah.
What are y'all thoughts on that, Joe? What you think?
Oh, that's what makes the NFL special, man. These streaming platforms, you know, they got the likes of Amazon, Peacock, YouTube,
Netflix now.
Netflix coming aboard. This has made a ripple in media, social media, tech landscape. So to me, the NFL vision is very simple. Money, 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 money. Get as much football to as many people as possible. Why? I can't say this enough. The NFL is king because they're – remember that line on Coming to America? When I said the man got his own money, the man got his own money. So the NFL is printing money on top of money. And then they got the face, not of just the Kansas City Chiefs, but of the NFL. Patrick Mahomes, number 15. Daddy be having DUIs. He's smoking on them Joe Burrows. Oh, my bad. Since let me hit you with that. And everything is good in the NFL hood. Everything. It's all good.
Man, what is
so hood. So hood.
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Man, what is you talking about, man? When the young boy be missing.
What am I talking
about? I asked you about the NBA on NBC, and you started telling me about the NFL.
Because, I mean, I don't care nothing about no NBA. I'm NFL, baby. I'm supposed to always follow the rules.
Yeah, I mean, it was great content. It was great. It was a great platform, but we weren't talking about that yet.
I don't remember that being in the notes about no NBA.
It's right there together. Listen,
I can't read very well.
Well, you know what's going to happen.
Hey, Clay, go ahead. Talk about whatever you want to talk about.
You're talking about the NBA.
Yeah. Whatever you want. To I think the Cosby Show was a great.
No, NBC what's going to happen is. What's going to happen is, you know, professional wrestling gonna go in on TNT and get that money. Watch.
Bring WCW back. Bring WCW back on TNT. I'm locked in. So Charles Barkley gonna be on the sideline. Hey man, hey, don't take me back to the 90s. I told you the 90s was the best decade ever.
But on that note, since I can't interject something about the NBA in the 90s. When the Knicks played against the Rockets in the finals, they interrupted the NBA game finals with the O.J. Simpson chase. That would introduce the world.
I'm here to tell you right now. We don't care.
Let me tell you, we don't care.
Man, we talking about that 4 weeks ago when OJ passed. Man, what is you talking about? Are you okay today? He said, I'm going to talk about anything but what you want to talk about, big dad.
Hey, you got it. You smart, ain't it? Sticks and stone may break my bones.
Okay, the NBC.
Jingling.
NBC. Jingling. We know them for having the Notre Dame game, but NBC would that really be on a Sunday, wouldn't it? I can't see them dropping on Tuesday nights and whatever. So I do think most of those games will go to streaming. Maybe Peacock on the Peacock network. So
Will you give us a take on the NBA since I couldn't produce the baby, right? So
that's what I'm saying. We're really gonna miss NBA on TNT, the show, you know, besides the game.
They can't duplicate that all-star cast. Who they gonna hire to? I don't know how long TNT had been around, but they've been around a lifetime for the NBA, and the NBA just decided not to re-sign that contract because they could have did that months ago in NBC when they had a shot at even getting it. But I guess TNT has grown stale of having it.
A lot of people was talking about how Chuck shouldn't go over to the, what's the junk called? The FLY, the SLY, the golf over in Iraq.
And I forgot
what it's called, but They was getting all the Tiger Woods want to go. He got too much money, but they were giving folks millions and millions of dollars to go play the LIV live golf.
That's why he going that money. He just donated some money to the Auburn University too, $1 million.
Yeah, but he wouldn't go. He wouldn't go when they wanted him to go, because by their beliefs, some it had to do with TNT. But he turned down a lot of money, and he talked about it on some of the local platforms that I follow.
And he's standing on principles.
Yeah, something
Drake don't know nothing about.
Yeah. Okay. But yeah, we got some streaming changes going down. NBA on NBC is coming back. Hopefully the Fighting Irish, they'll find a platform and get off NBC and find a conference.
They ain't gonna do that.
NFL is milking everybody's pockets. They now you got to have Netflix, you got to have Preflix and Suffix and just to watch the NFL games.
Oh, look at it.
If you're not like us. But I don't
pay for it. You coming around to get it.
Prime, Amazon Prime to watch Thursday night. Or just go to Wild Wings. I don't know. But NFL is making some money, man. But we're gonna watch those games. We're gonna find especially the fantasy football and gambling. Some of these sites, they're running football. They're making football king. NFL was already king, and yeah, so they're gonna find a way to watch games, and people gonna pay, and the NFL gonna get paid, and the players need, but the NBA players have better contracts and better insurance and things of that nature. So
Verizon got an app you can watch the game on your phone too, don't?
Yeah, I guess, but I got some sites that I get down with, but
let me put me up on games, send it over to me.
We'll do.
You know, there is some poor folks in this war.
Yeah. Well, I know they ain't on this screen. Well, they're not here. But listen, we're gonna watch the NFL games regardless, streaming or not. Okay. Name three games that are must see football. I put specifically first.
I realized I didn't
make sure that my games I picked were in the first half of the season.
It made no sense.
But let's do it. Because my Falcons, the last six games supposed to be cupcake. But let's see. Clutch, three must see games.
First game, you know, I'm going to talk about is September 22nd.
I don't know.
The Ravens and the Cowboys. Next must-see game is going to be September the 12th. I think the Bills and the Dolphins. It's going to be a pretty good game. And last but not least, October 6th. The Cowboys and the Steelers. And we're going to wax that ass. No diddy.
No way. Ain't no way. Balls.
Damn. Balls. So wax that ass.
Lock your right now. Go on, lock your
wax that ass and no diddy means something totally different after this weekend, the video. That's crazy. Yeah. Prayers to everybody involved besides that guy. Look, I like the way you did that. You broke your three games down, and I could clip that. I can clip it. And now we can talk about how trash your list is after.
Yeah, I can clip it.
I clip it and put it in the short. And then people can come in like, hey, that guy knows what he's talking about, man. He must be as smart as he looks. Or what they can say, man. On water.
Pitching woo on the job. Drink, what you... podcasting is ranking. What is it? That nigga cold, boy.
Hey, listen.
Light skin stepping up. Light skin stepping up in this world. I'm proud of you, man. God, I ain't know you.
Jiggling.
Speaking of pitching, where your boy at, man? Sims. Metris.
Wait, what's up? What's up?
Give me looking three.
There you go.
Give me three must see games.
You see how you clown Pittsburgh? You should have went to me, Nick. But don't. I'm all right with that. But go ahead, carry on. I'm sorry, I'm talking too much.
Games. I will say I want to see the rematch with Kansas City and the Ravens. Generally, the Ravens, and even though Jackson won the MVP, he has more to prove based on the last game they had. Also, I'm going to say San Fran and KC. I think that's a good game, just a rematch of the Super Bowl. So I think that'll be a good outlet. And the third game is any random eight games the Cowboys play, because that's going to be hilarious. All right, we're going to see Jerry Jones. Hey, I'm starting to think Jerry Jones and Mr. Burns are one and the same. That's what I'm starting to think from the Simpsons.
Facts.
Jerry's always because y'all, when they win the game, going, did we win the game? Did we win?
Yeah. Did we win? I just think the Cowboys, and it's not because of the players, because guess what, Clutch? I got high respect for the players, right? Y'all got some dogs, but your owner just messed everything up. I was just telling these Gen Z, you skip the coach to go right to the owner, and then the owner don't know nothing about football. He just write the check, and then he overseeing the coach. Let the coach do his job. That's one thing I respect about the Pittsburgh Steelers. No matter what it is, they put all on the head coach. And if he gets fired, at least we can say it was him. Jerry Jones is an accident waiting to happen. He's a privileged billionaire. We already know how he became a billionaire. I mean, we knew who was in Texas doing all that. We ain't about to go all that.
Ooh. Ooh.
Right? And then all of a sudden, a privileged billionaire who never could start at Arkansas, now he knows everything about football. The best thing he did for that team was buying it from whoever and hired Jimmy Johnson. And the worst thing he did was firing him because of his ego. That man is hot garbage. He in the LeBron category with me. I don't know who works. And his son is Bronny James. He asked me.
Man, what are you talking about, man?
I just want to include LeBron with that, too.
No, man.
I gave you three. I said any game they're playing. You can pick any Cowboy game, because that's going to be hilarious.
I will say this, and this is an exclusive on the Set Your Lineup podcast, episode 10. Zeke will rush for 12 to 1,500 yards this year. You heard it here first.
What you want on that? Yeah, put him on mute. I put him on mute.
Let's make sure I'm in the phone call.
All of that.
He gonna rush for 1,200. He must be counting the preseason and the mandatory mini camps.
He still on.
Man, hey, that man built that man ate himself into a nose tackle.
He letting them little videos. He
gonna rush for $150 on the Saints.
He must be running backwards. If he get if he get that, he doing punt return, backwards, kick return.
Backwards.
He must be the kick angle, strip fumble somebody. Gonna be a whole lot of stuff going on.
Hey man, listen. Hey, I don't have too many rules. I mean, cause this is our show. This is our show, so I don't want to be the one to try to make rules and come up with things of that nature. But
normal people start a talk off like that. That's exactly what they're trying to do. But go ahead.
I mean, it has to be some substance and some. It has to be some standard somewhere. Listen, okay. I mean, serious. I'm dead serious. All if right. you are trying to get one of those,
listen up.
If you are trying to get one of those checks, don't use our podcast to do it, okay? Don't come on here and just say crazy.
Well, you know, Stephen A. said about the Cowboy fans.
Man, what is wrong with you?
The weed. Every day.
Because I think he come on here and then when he get down there, he going to say, hey, I'm on the podcast. And look at this. And they just going to write him out a check. Don't use this show to prove you can get one of them checks, man.
Make the rich richer.
Now he gonna come here next week with a Luna Ford hat and everything.
trying to make an alien.
But you might got some money on the game. You got some money on the game.
Which one?
On the
Indiana.
Oh yeah, we should get ready to get up out of here. Knicks
okay. Come hey man, I'm a little clueless what happened. What I missed?
That man just got on here, cuz they got on here and started talking about the man gonna run for 1,500. He gonna run for 150 against the Saints and all that. And I'm thinking, can you say crazy shit? I think he's trying to get a crazy shit by using this platform to.
Hey,
I told y'all some episodes before we're gonna start drug testing on for the podcast, man.
I think he did. He look that serious, like he. but the crazy thing, what if he's right?
Nah.
What if the wide receivers of the Dolphins have 3,000 yards?
Zeke is not going to start. The guy there that's already there going to be starting over Zeke.
That man said the guy there. Well, look, we were naming three.
Is my internet just acting up?
It might be. Everybody else great?
We great.
You said I sound like a robot.
I ain't get my three games, though. What's up? You overlooking me?
I didn't get my three games, neither.
Well, you go first, then. Go ahead. Age before beauty.
Well, my must-see three games will be the Steelers at the Broncos.
Must-see.
Yeah, Steelers at Broncos.
YouTube TV.
What Red Sea said?
Look, Steelers at the Broncos. You got what's his name? Sierra husband. You got Russell. Sierra husband going back to Denver to play against probably Bo Nix. So that's gonna be a good game. Just the atmosphere.
Bo Nix and must see TV should never be mentioned in the same breath. And you a Bama fan. Bo Nix and must-see I'm interrupting your list.
It was must-see TV when he beat the brace off Dion. When Bo Nix beat the brace off Dion, millions tuned in for that. Mm. Millions tuned in for that. But look, we want to see y'all starting quarterback. I guess it'll still be the starting quarterback. Russell Wilson go into Denver and win that game. It's going to be good television. Honorable mention, I had the Steelers at the Falcons because it's first game of the year and another return. Who did that? Somebody did something. Something start echo. Our old coach, Arthur Smith, will be returning to Atlanta.
We're going to turn up.
As an offensive coordinator. To stink up the joint one more time. So that is an honorable mention.
Podcast might just be in Atlanta that weekend.
Might just be.
Put it out there for y'all. Yeah.
Somebody might be broke coming back.
Hey.
Stroke us all weekend.
Hey, Pin Up.
I make it rain.
Pin Up. Podcast live in Pin Up. Me and my son crazy.
Live from Strokers. Foxy Lady.
Ravens. The Ravens
and
had the
whole world loves it when you don't get da da da.
The Ravens and at Chargers. Hey, let me get my three on, man.
The Chargers.
The Ravens at the Chargers. You got the Brother Bowl. They were my games coming from, man, because all the season gonna be good, but I like the little notes.
You better not talk about my homeboy X no more. I thought nobody do no worse what he did, and here you come.
Man, you gonna hear?
you did a 360 with Vince Carter off the backboard, nothing but nets.
I'm a member of the media, and the media is gonna go crazy about these games. About Russell Wilson returning to Denver, about the brothers playing again since the Super Bowl.
The brother.
The Harbaugh Bars. the Harlem Hardball Bars.
Who has it better than us? Nobody.
And Arthur Smith returning to Atlanta with the Steelers on the first game of the year. The schedule makers know what they're doing.
We're going
to
dominate.
And also, you got the Falcons going to Minnesota. Well, Kirk Cousins will return to Minnesota and play.
All your games got Atlanta in it. Sure.
I got two Steelers and two. I got two Steelers, two Atlanta. Because yeah. I had Steelers versus Atlanta. So hey.
You got two chains that live in Atlanta.
Yeah, that. So let me get your three. What's going to be some of the oldest people playing each other?
2 40-year-old quarterbacks.
This is Howard Cosell. You probably know how Cosell is, though.
I do.
All right, three games. Opening night. Everybody should have this on your list. The Baltimore Ravens versus the Kansas City Chiefs. Kicking the season off with the champions of the world. You got two MVPs, young guys that's going to carry the lead for many, many years to come. Played each other previously in the playoffs. So why not put to kick the season off the right way, which the NFL always finds a way to hit a home run in football season. Number two, also week one, Jets versus the 49ers. The Jets coach used to be the defensive coordinator with the 49ers, and he established a dominant defense with the 49ers. Went to the Jets. It was a miserable losing team, and he has established an elite defense with the Jets. Also, Aaron Rodgers is still upset with the 49ers because he went to school in California. California kid. He thought he'd be the number one quarterback drafted that year, but it was Alex Smith. And as we know, Aaron Rodgers dropped down the board and went in the late 20s or something, maybe even the 30s. So that's going to be a great game. And it's got a lot of question marks on Aaron Rodgers, but it's giving him an opportunity because they opened up last year on a Monday night. So giving a Monday night again to show the world that New York is in the building, Aaron Rodgers is in the building, league defense with the coach, almost fired by having that guy who couldn't play quarterback last year. So it's going to be a great game. Last one, week five, Cowboys versus the Steelers. One of the most historic rivalries in the history of football. You can't tell the story of football without mentioning these two franchises, two of the winning most franchises. And also, they played each other three times in the Super Bowl, and we beat them two out of the last three times. And the last time the Cowboys was in the Super Bowl, they beat us in 95. But it's been a long, long time since they've been there. But we're going to introduce them to more heartache because long as they got that, we ain't worried about nothing. We ain't worried about Jack.
So who's that quarterback?
You don't even want to pay that man.
What's his name? Who's that quarterback for y'all? He playing for us that Super Bowl.
Paid him because he threw two interceptions to Super Bowl MVP.
Neil O'Donnell.
I can't think. And I'm probably the guy that got the interception.
Neil O'Donnell.
Oh, I can't think of his name because he got a contract with the Raiders after that.
Oh, you don't know Darren.
It wasn't Woody, was it? Wilson?
No, Darren Wilson stayed with Cowboy the whole time. He replaced Kevin Smith because Kevin Smith got hurt that year.
I can't remember his name.
He trash, though. He was trash. God, I can't think of his name.
He'll come to me in a second.
And this Grandpa Memory Lane moment has been brought to you by Raisins, California Raisins.
I'm going to say California Raisins. Give me my – I want me some – I can't eat no Jell-O after watching that, man. Put on some clothes.
Oh, all right, I know a lot of y'all three games involve. I mean, a lot of y'all involve the Chiefs in your in one of your top games. Can the question Trigger Man Joe had for the cast? Can the Chiefs three-peat? Unpredictable. Do you think the Chiefs can three-peat?
Yeah, you got the best quarterback in the league. You upgraded the receiver spot. Not sure how the young man from Texas is going to be, but I think his speed alone is going to open up a lot of windows for Patrick Mahomes. And I think behind the scenes, towards the end, I think we fail to realize and actually acknowledge how the Chiefs' defense went from almost worst to first. So rather put a lot of pressure on Mahomes, I think he extended his career as far as his health. It's like he low managed like LeBron, but he's still playing. So everything is not on him strictly. So the defense steps up. They make, you know, timely sacks and things like that. So if you go back to when Mahomes first started, the first year, offsides by D Ford, the game over with. So I don't see why they won't. Me personally, I like what the Chiefs do. I like when teams build from the beginning, LeBron, instead of trying to just get all these big name free agents and coach your guys up you know, do what you're supposed to do as a coach. Because I don't know the exact quote, but one thing I love that Mike Tomlin said was something to the effect that when the coach said that a kid or a player can't do something, that's a lazy way out because the coach don't know what he's doing. So, hey, props to Andy Reid, because whatever they're doing, he's worked it to the T, and I'm going to say this again, he's able to load manage Patrick Mahomes. That's why you don't see him running around the field all day and still keep him in the game and just say, let's rely on the defense, and when we need a big play like the Super Bowl, you do your thing. Something LeBron can't do, but go ahead.
Ooh, shots fired.
Just in case y'all don't know, I don't really care for LeBron's game.
Larry Brown, Trigger Man.
That's exactly who it is. That's exactly who it is.
Great.
It's like the head coach or the cornerback?
The cornerback for the Cowboys. He was the third string quarterback. Cornerback.
I was a little confused because they came out of nowhere. I thought he was talking about I was like Larry Brown, so I started looking at the screen because I know he used to coach for the Pacers.
Yeah,
Nice insert.
All right, Clutch, can the Chiefs three-peat? Try to keep it under 5 minutes, like unlike my son.
I mean, I think they have the tools to do it. They just got to catch the ball. I mean, they're still going to have a high-powered offense. Their defense is The D-line should be okay. They traded away what's his name? I can't think of his name. Anyway, they traded him away.
Snead.
But I think they have a great chance, because as long as they got that bad light skin, man, anything is possible.
Yeah, good deal. I don't think they – I mean, I hear a lot of chances and this. I don't think they will. I'd rather bet – if I had to bet them or the field, I'd rather bet the field. And I think that they are being used this NFL season to Taylor Swift, Super Bowl, New Orleans. That's going to be the move. I see that they play 3 games in 16 days in a time period this season. I also see that they play the first NFL team to ever play 6 different days of the week. They will have a game on Sunday, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. So that I think they will be. But if Taylor Swift going to be performing in the Super Bowl, why not have the Chiefs there again? But I don't think they will win it. So what you got, Trigger Man Joe? Do you think this is a possibility?
Of course they can repeat, but they will not repeat. Unfortunately, when you're that good, you can't retain everybody on your squad. You're going to lose people to free agency, and then you're going to have to pay a lot of your older veterans, like that mountain of a man in the middle, is escaping me his name, but y'all know who he is. But to me, the biggest hurdle against them is this word called distractions. Rasheed Rice, with his alleged allegations and potential legal issues. The field goal kicker, he just shut his mouth up and kicked field goals. Harrison Buckner, with his controversial speech. The NFL has distanced itself from the remarks he has made. I wouldn't be surprised if they cut him, but distraction is a big-time killer when you're trying to repeat as champions. And the last degree of difficulty is what DJ Yellowboy was talking about, the schedule. Very, very difficult schedule. But my last cherry on the top, if anybody can do it, 15 can do it. 15 ain't from this planet, y'all. That man put on the cape. He really put on the cape, man. To me, he's the greatest in history, and he got a long career. Well, hopefully he have a long career. You never know what might happen, but he got to do nothing else. He's the greatest quarterback I ever seen in my life.
Whoa.
Yeah. Ain't up for debate.
Mm-hmm. Well, there you have it. We all really think the Chiefs can make the Super Bowl. And
Taylor Swift performing at the Super Bowl?
Nah, that's what I put my money on.
If she performed, they're going to make it. But they're going to lose it, though. They ain't gonna, no team has ever three-peated.
If Lil Wayne performing, the Chiefs will not make it.
They're not even making it to the Super Bowl. They're going to get knocked out of the
league. I believe the Chiefs have a better chance of making the Super Bowl than Lil Wayne.
I thought you were going to say the Steelers, but yeah, you safe. Because I'm about to unload on you, Falcon. Oh, my God. Falcon, man.
So, we got the NBA draft lottery just happened. The NFL would have made a big thing about it if they had that, but that slipped past my gates. It slipped past my gates that was happening. Anybody catch the draft lottery or excited about it or anything?
I will say the team in the West that you need to look out for next year is going to be San Antonio.
Well, why is that?
Well, they got two picks. They got the fourth and the eighth pick in the from the lottery, and I mean,
what if they pick a scrub and a bust?
You talking about adding people around Wimby, so and they may trade those picks to maybe get a veteran, a couple of veterans in there, to help Wimby out. So I think the Spurs would be the team out of the West next year.
Out of the West. The team with the fourth pick, you think
I said it. They got the fourth and the eighth pick. They got two picks, man. Come on.
Ooh.
Yeah. Ah.
And they can use those picks, man.
This is one of the best drafts since 96 and 04. I got my $5 to your toenail that you can't name more than
I can't even name the number one pick off the top of my head.
what's he got?
I know nobody getting drafted. I ain't gonna lie. I don't know anybody.
Hey, you know why we don't know nobody getting drafted? You know why? Because they keep on talking about a future number 47 pick because of his dad. That's why you don't know nobody else. Man shot two for eight. They talking about, you know what? He improved his draft stock. Hey, see, everybody was so busy talking. See, Joe, Trigger Man, I did my homework. First of all, he was 4 for 10 the second game, and it was so excited. Now, Jordan shot 49%. They said that was bad, but he shot 40%. So how do you shoot 40%, right? And on top of shooting 40%, you come the day before, he shot 25%. They left that part off. So I think this is the problem between hating and reality. If I say Joe is not a, if I say Joe is just not the, the best fantasy football player, that, I mean, fantasy football owner, that's hating. All right. Because I'm coming to some bad facts when the man's won championships. But when Joe goes, he don't win a game and never won a championship, and I say he's horrible, those are facts. Hating is when it's not real, and we're trying to make somebody look bad. I have never seen a man, let me say that for Bronny. Bronny, you know, everybody's entitled to go to the league. And guess what? He might carve out a nice career and be Austin Rivers part two. That's fine. 13 years, whatever. But I have never seen so much hype for a guy who averaged 9 points in high school, 4 points in college, and they saying what he could be. And I'm just saying, I get tired of the number 47 picked by the Lakers. And we talking about this man all day. I don't even know who else in the draft.
I don't either.
Can we get somebody who's going to be a top 10 pick at least? That's all I ask.
Now, I know that you don't like his daddy. Is it a fair assessment that you don't like his son as well?
I like the kid. I feel bad for the kid because I feel like it's a lot of pressure. But LeBron is pepping his son. Hey, you get my son, you get me. What the hell? Can he get it on his own merit? I had a lot of respect when Bronny said, trying to get me to get my daddy, let me stay in the draft. I respect that. Because at the end of the day, let the man get it. If he gets in there, that's fine. We're not saying he can't. And I'm not saying he don't deserve to be in the NBA. If they draft you, you deserve to. But, right, man, you averaging 4 points a game. I don't want to see you on TV every day. Only time I want to see somebody score 4 points a game on TV if they playing soccer, not basketball.
Last week, you were saying people can make the NBA without having to be a scorer. That's when you said the NFL crap last week. True. Now you got the score. Now you got to score more.
No. So, here's the thing.
No.
Yo, hold up. I never said he don't deserve. I just said I don't want to see his ass on TV. Hey, Patrick Beverly played defense, but I don't want to see him every day on TV scoring 10 points a game. Give me somebody else. Guess what? The NFL don't make money putting Kirk Cousins on prime time. They put Patrick Mahomes, Lamar
Jackson. Facts.
So here's the thing. Even, guess what? You could have Kirk Cousins and say he's a nice player, but don't put him on TV every week, shutting him down my throat. I don't want to see that.
You like that?
Hey, now I'm going to give you facts.
No, Diddy.
Right? Hey. Hey, Bronny Bronny in warm-ups took his time running from spot to spot and shot 19 for 25, but nobody guarding him. No better pressure from him.
Better than unpredictable.
Now, watch this. Guess what? He played 25 games for USC and only made 16. You see that? Ooh. So my thing is, he might average 30 one day. If he do, that's fine. No, but right now, he was, hey, outside of his daddy, he won't be the number 30th pick. When we respected Draymond and said he's a perennial Hall of Famer, when he went on the NBA court and did it, not what he did in a pre-draft lottery. I think this is horrible. I want to know who's the number. I don't even know the number one pick right now.
I don't know a thing. I looked at the other day, but
I don't even think Bronny would be drafted. I think they'll pick him up.
He's going to be drafted.
You ain't saying nothing right the whole career. He's
going to be drafted. Ain't no doubt about it.
If you ask me, and this is facts, and I watched the young man, and you know how somebody said that scoring 30 points in Alabama for basketball is different. It's like scoring 13 in California. Right now, I'll take LaGelo Ball before I take LeBron James.
Mm-hmm. Boy.
Even the president got him from China.
The thing I don't get about it, how listed as like 6'3 all throughout high school, and they measure him at the combine, magically he's 6 feet, 6'1 or whatever, whatnot. So why would you fabricate his height? He's really too small to be nothing but a point guard in the league, and so many scouts have said that they don't see him as an NBA player, so anybody with any common sense, but common sense ain't common these days, would know that he is not an NBA player. Not saying that he can't become one, but at this present time, he haven't even been a college player. You know, with all that juice coming out of high school.
Was it dad a college player? Was his dad a college player?
Brady had to go to college.
No. What college did he go to? What college did he go to?
He didn't go to college. Kevin
Garnett didn't go to college. Kobe didn't go to college.
So what are you talking about? What are you talking about?
He did go to college.
He ain't certified.
He went to the University of PED.
I mean, they do this in the NFL all the time. In the glorious NFL with glorious position at quarterback. You had John Wall come in the NBA. Not John Wall. The one barely played at Duke. Kyrie
Irving.
Yeah, I mean, you. Some people ain't meant for college.
Man, so, wait, hold on. Maybe I missed something, but
you talk about all time greats mentioning in the same breath with Bronny James. Come on, man.
Wait, you don't know what Bronny can do.
But I'm about to say this. Hey, and if here go to public, if I'm hating, say I'm hating, we don't know what he gonna be, right? Everything is based on potential. But when have we seen a guy average 9 points in high school and 4 points in college, and now he's predicted right now to be a late second round pick.
All right, unpredictable
about him every day.
Unpredictable. Yeah. What is Alex Sarr gonna do?
So I don't even know who he is because I've been looking at Bronny James.
What is Reed Sheppard gonna do?
Do better than Bronny.
They're gonna do better than Bronny.
What is Donovan Clingan gonna do?
They're gonna do better than Bronny.
What school did Bob Dillingham go to, Mr. What College? What school he went to?
Basketball. I don't know.
Zachariah Rishaster.
I know the big white boy Purdue. He from Purdue. I can't even think of his name.
And he ain't going first round, so that shows them no.
He ain't going first round.
He's not projected for first round. No. Wow. Ron Holland.
Etney.
Zach Etney. They got him projected number 9 at.
You said he wasn't going first round.
At Memphis. I thought you were talking about. But you don't know his name.
I just said that Eddie. What's his name?
Eddie. But he done played 4 years for Purdue.
Yeah, you got
it. So we know when you play 4 years, my man coming out, he ain't played but 6-7 games in college.
Tim Duncan played 4 years. Played 4 years.
Uh-huh.
Tim Duncan.
He was learning the language.
Tim Duncan was a.
Oh, Tristan Da Silva. Cody Williams.
What's the guy that hit the
touchdown? Y'all don't know. Isaiah,
you know why?
Isaiah Collins.
Here's the thing. And I think we all guilty of this. That clutch.
Allen don't hit the three. Tim Duncan is 6-0 in the finals. Like Michael Jordan.
Hey, clutch. How about this? We'll say this. Again, I don't know what his ceiling is. Everybody has a ceiling, right? You can graduate from high school with all these and have a ceiling to be a millionaire. We're not saying that LeBron, like Bronny James, can't be great. I never said that. He might surprise everybody, and his game may flourish in the pros more than anything. I'm not saying that. What I am saying is that Gino just gave some names. I'll go even further. You got Penny Hardaway's son. You got Kenyon Martin's son. You got Melo's son. You got all these former NBA player sons and even some All-Americans that was high school All-Americans last year. It was a big boy from Florida. He transferred from Duke. All these guys scored 5 points or less, and we really don't hear nothing about them. And the one person who scored 4 points a game, it's like he's the media coverage. So we rely on the television, like the media coverage, to let us know who is who. When the young man Xavier ran a 4.240, we didn't really know who he was. But then all of a sudden, he ran a 4.240. The media put him out. So now we know speed kills in the NFL.
You knew who he was because he burned Alabama.
Austin Rivers, y'all just climbed him a few seconds ago. He was awesome at Duke. At Duke.
So I just say the cup. I think, how about this? Some of the names you gave, if I was to go back and just give a random name and you looked at his stats and I said he going to be a Hall of Famer one day, y'all would laugh at me. Thanks. So what I'm trying to say is, based on what I've seen, I'm going to go back. Don't quote me on this, but I remember his sophomore year, he averaged 4 points a game in high school. Then he went to 9 points a game and then 13. Here's the thing. When you look at Jordan and Pippen, we know Jordan was the alpha. Pippen was second. Bronny James was always second or third. But the problem is every year it was somebody new that became first. So when do you step up and be the man? Then you go to USC. Your daddy said there's not a winning culture. But my thing is, I don't even remember USC being a basketball school to win. So my thing is, why would you send him to USC? Now he's leaving 4-2-3. And for all those LeBron fans that hate on Michael Jordan, and I know who you are. Taiwan, I'm calling you by name. Y'all was laughing at Michael Jordan stats. His son, talking about, look at Marcus Jordan. He had 8 points his freshman year. He garbage. So if Marcus Jordan had 8 points a game, 4 rebounds, 4 assists, and LeBron James' son got less than that, how are we hating on somebody who scored 4 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists? Locally, DJ Davidson, his numbers exceeded Bronny James everywhere. He was a second-round pick, and we don't even defend him. LeBron James' son might be great, but right now I don't want to hear about the projected number 47 pick in the draft.
Okay. Here's my take on right quick, and I'm going to get out of the way. I do not think the kid want to play basketball.
Breaking news.
I think it's something else in life he wants to do, but his daddy won't allow him to do it. Just look at his expression when he's out there playing. He don't even look happy. He don't look motivated to prove the naysayers. Well,
breaking news. Jalen Brunson has fractured his hand and will be out for the remainder of game 7. And yeah, they are getting their keister kicked. Mm.
It won't be no repeat of 1994.
Why did it run in front of the police and the Bronco? That was supposed to happen this year.
That was
and one of the new Broncos. But
this short clip of him being happy playing basketball. He just out there doing something to be doing. No type of you don't get
let the kid be a kid. Be
yeah, he don't want to do it.
Oh, yeah, insane.
Look at him. Let's go look at the tape. With his interviews, it's not that they show that he breathes basketball. That he wants to be great. He wants to challenge.
He don't want to be looked at as LeBron's son.
His baby brother. His big brother. If it ain't your big brother,
know what he do? Learn from the real GOAT, Jordan. Hey, learn from Jordan. You know what Jordan did when Pippen started talking smack about him? He put markers on him and took his wife.
That, first of all,
because guess what they say, real G's moving silent. Jordan didn't say nothing when Pippen was slaughtered. Pippen on a book tour, a whole book tour, the whole time he sliced.
She belongs to the streets.
That wasn't nobody's wife, okay?
Hey, for all we know, Bronny might take her a lot. Let the man be. Let him be who?
The future have her too with the flip flops or something.
Yeah,
hey, guess what? As much as I've read Bronny, I be on Bronny, I feel bad for him, man, because let the man figure out his life.
Yeah, I don't think he wants to play basketball. I'm not saying it to be. I believe that. I stand on
that. And at 6 feet,
Trigger Man, I mean, I can see that because he was more happier in high school than he is now. I will say that.
As they go on, he gets more miserable and miserable.
Because a lot of times when kids like that, they go traditionally, when they go to pros knowing they didn't live up to those top 30 high school rankings, it's because they're trying to feed their family. So I can't be mad if Bronny James lived in Smiley Court and he had a chance to even play in the G League, even though we know that's a death sentence for basketball players. But he still can make $500,000. So for a place like Montgomery, $500,000, you rich, you wealthy. Now he could take his family and move him out the Pike Road and get his family away from all the violence and the nonsense. You know what I would say? Go pro. Come on, man. Your daddy a billionaire. We know you set for life. There's nothing wrong with nepotism because guess what? If I could do it, I would do it too. But sometimes we lose sight on our vision for our kids instead of themselves. Let them figure it out.
Well, Brandon got a good vision. According to Daily Law, Brandon makes $5.9 million from his NIL deals with companies like Nike, Beats by Dre, and PSD Underwear. Second on the list, can you guess who?
Travis Hull?
Who?
Deion Sanderson?
Deion Sanderson. Second on the list, Colorado Buffalo quarterback Shedeur Sanders, who earns $4.8 million from his deal. Hey, it is what it is, man. Do we say, I mean, well, we know Shedeur wants to play. We know he loves.
Yeah, you can tell. Yeah, he loves the game. But,
oh man.
Yeah, you can see it. Hold on. Evidence.
You must say. And here's the difference.
Listen, listen. Clutch, clutch, clutch. Come on the camera. Clutch, chill, and he say his things, and he say his he give his point and have his quotes and all that. But just because he ain't bouncing all across the screen don't mean he don't want to be on this podcast. He's here every week.
Being on the podcast and playing sports is two different things, homie.
I'm saying that man right now.
I know what you're trying to say, Gino.
No, you know what I'm saying.
Just, Gino don't even know what he's trying to say.
You know what I'm saying. You can't judge.
So hold on.
You can't judge nobody whether they want.
Can I ask you a question? Maybe it's me.
Stuff that you see.
Hey, maybe it's me.
It's free will. Bronny, you do what you want to do in life. What are you talking about? You can't.
Bronny made his money. He gonna make his money, right? I don't care about nepotism, because if I could get my son to the league, I would. Now I wouldn't pimp him out, say you draft my son, I'm coming. I wouldn't do that. But behind the scenes, I'd be like, draft my son. Right? If I'm gonna do something like that, it's gonna be a wink wink, like, I got you. What I'm trying to say is that you say Shedeur Sanders is second. Take the what we assume as emotion of they love the game or not. Can we say even last year, is it plausible to say that his son, Sanders, was one of the top 6-7 quarterbacks in the nation last year?
No.
Not his team, but him.
No.
You don't
I don't think he would have been drafted before Bo Nix.
No. I'm not saying that who would be drafted first, but
wouldn't be drafted as a top 7 quarterback last year.
All right, so now, after Bo Nix, who's the next quarterback?
I think
Bo Nix was the last quarterback in the first round. He was number 6.
Probably the cat from South Carolina.
Yeah,
Rattler. Yeah,
Spencer Rattler, whatever he was.
You think Rattler would have went before Sanders?
No.
No way, no way, no way.
So what I'm saying is this:
top 3 pick.
Where?
Even last year
was.
No, he probably turned around.
But you ain't got no quarterback coming out this year. Okay.
I'm gonna look at the stats. If I look at his stats, first of all, let's look at the team that they have. Bo Nix, and I say this, when he was with Auburn, everybody said he was garbage. I said that man can play. He got the wrong team. He went out to Oregon, looked like an All-American. Penix was with Indiana, didn't look good. Got to Washington with talent, first round draft pick. Daniel struggled at Arizona State. You get to LSU, first round draft pick. What I'm saying was set the difference between those quarterbacks and Shedeur. I don't have the numbers in front of me. Put his numbers last year with a 3-8 team and how he was trying to carry a team with no O-line and put his numbers against anybody in the country. He stacks up.
Oh, yeah, no question.
Bronny, if you take his points, rebounds, and assists and just say, hey, give him 2 + 2 + 2 = 8, he's still in double digits in points. So,
I mean, why didn't he play in college. How are you going to play in the pros? He ain't playing college. He need to go back to college. The game, because obviously he don't know the game.
Did his daddy play at college? He ain't his daddy. Kwame Brown play at college?
Number one overall.
Did Stephen A. Smith play at college?
Yeah.
They average the same point.
But I'm saying, how you gonna, man? All the other clowns is on the front of this mock draft. Then play in college. You can't recognize them from a can of paint, Joe. So cut that out,
man. And they better than Brown.
You got quarterbacks that were drafted from North Dakota State that ain't played well for nothing. Aaron Rodgers ain't playing well for nothing in college.
Yes, he was. That was a bad man.
Yes, he did. What you talking about?
The one that played for the Chiefs.
Alex Smith. Oh, he was the truth.
In college.
Yeah.
Come on, man. You got quarterback.
Romo was
you got Patrick Mahomes that bounced around. Pause.
No, but they played for a weaker team.
All right.
Well, how about this? Forget about what we said. How about this, Joe?
Your room,
and Gino? Let's be fair. Everybody he named that wasn't, let's just say they numbers didn't stack up, right? Let's go with that. You know what they did that Bronny didn't do in college?
Talk to
it. Start a game.
Okay.
So at least you saw a starter.
He was behind Carly. All right, listen. All right, we're going to get up out of here.
Was Bronny, was he Mac Dog? Was he McDonald? Was he McDonald All-American? McDonald All-American? I don't know. I'm asking.
Yes.
Hey, just like they say, like,
yes,
a clock, a broken
clock. What did he do in that game? What's his points in that game?
Who watched that?
Hey.
I like
clock is right twice a day, right?
When Garnett and Kobe were playing back in the day.
I know he's trying to say that he can be Drew Holiday. You can't. I'm not going to sit there and shatter the man's dreams. But let's look at the facts of what we see with people that fit Bronny's stature. He got a better chance of being Scooter Penn and Mateen Cleaves out the league in 2 years than he does have to be Drew Holiday.
Man, where are y'all with speaking of Scooter Penn or whoever that may be?
Ohio State Buckeyes, come back and look.
Yeah,
and he was an All-American.
He was a monster in college.
No, where my boy Scoot? Y'all was beasting up all
that. Overseas?
No, I'm talking the one that went to the Trailblazers.
Oh,
yeah. Henderson. Yeah, what was he popping?
Did he perform?
Y'all was boosting him up. Speaking of college, we finna get ready to get out of here. Speaking of college, one of the greatest college athletes ever has made her way into the WNBA. How have y'all been checking out that?
I haven't watched
Angel. Checking out what?
Caitlin Clark.
No, I haven't watched nothing.
Well, tomorrow night, y'all
check. I don't know what episode it was. I told y'all that she was going to be a bust. I know it's still early. Y'all laughed at me and said, what? You must be doing drugs, this and that. She
you just not... got on here caping for college and what people do in college. Make your mind up.
It don't always transition, cuz.
Waste the last 20 minutes of my life telling me about college, hey. And asking what college they
man,
go to?
Man, I just blessed
man,
your
make
life.
Your mind
you don't
up.
Even recognize. You didn't
make
even
your
say
mind
you.
Up. Do that college
hey,
Joe,
young folks, you do don't listen, and don't. You don't know Jack.
Clutch. I stand corrected, and I'm willing to make it. Hey, I want anybody to take this bet. Scooter Henderson averaged 14 points, 3 rebounds, 5 assists. I guarantee you, Bronny won't even get half of that.
He won't even start. He's going to be in the G League for 2-3 years.
So yeah. y'all gonna try to compare the man to the number 3 pick in the NBA draft?
Well, you brought him up, not me. You said what happened to him.
You started talking about Scoop.
Oh, listen, with unpredictable, all roads lead back to Bronny and LeBron.
Facts, and I'm tired of it.
Now, here you go. Let's go back to the WNBA.
You can name all these great college people that didn't do squat in the NBA, and you can name people that perform in the NBA that ain't do nothing in college.
Yeah, it's not
but, a good say this,
so quit that, Joe.
Hey, this is what I want to say. I'm quit not it. Saying that people, hey, Clutch, I'm not
LeBron,
saying
LeBron,
team LeBron supposed to be
quit.
Good, right? I'm not saying because you are All-American in college, you're going to be successful. And I'm not saying because you wasn't, you that you won't be successful in the NBA. What I'm saying is I never saw in the NBA draft combine on ESPN, Fox, and every sports show possible. We're talking about a kid that averaged 4-2-2. That's all I said. Let the man get his –
It's because the people that wish to hate on the boy.
I know LeBron I know LeBron taking some PEDs. I wonder if there's any drugs that can make Bronny grow. You know, like after the day, he drew like 6 inches over the summer. Paul George grew, I think, 4 inches over one summer or whatever. So he's going to need a growth spurt.
Hey, yo, that's crazy.
Solidify.
But you know what? I'll go back on topic for you. Let me tell you what's wrong with the WNBA. And I'm just hear me out. And I don't care if they hear. This is where the NFL get it right. And sometimes basketball gets it wrong. Caitlin Clark is the WNBA's ticket right now to get nationally recognized, right? This is what I would do if I was in the WNBA. And this is what the old commissioner got it right, and the new one sometimes gets it wrong. If Caitlin Clark is the buzz for a league you haven't had since your first year, the defense should be changed where you allow her to shoot. And when they get too close up on her, you call foul. Because right now, you have to give her the green light to do what she does.
You're right.
To keep the sport going. But instead,
to get that money.
It's the competitive. And it's not just women.
Too much ice.
It's not just women because men do it too. Just like when Lonzo Ball came in and they trying to D-up. We know he a kid, right? He wouldn't. Now, I'll say this again. It's just kind of like when, and I'm not saying LeBron wouldn't. They played Denver in the playoffs 5 years ago. He D'd up Murray when he couldn't do nothing. He ain't doing that now. Let Caitlin, and this is from the money spot, because if I'm trying to watch Caitlin.
What LeBron did?
Yeah, he D'd up Murray when he was 19, but now he a grown man at 24. He don't want no part of that.
Yes.
But let Caitlin shine. My thing is, if I'm the WNBA players, you got to have sense to say she is bringing in the market. She's getting 13,000 in an arena. That means if she's coming and she's scoring, you can stop her and her team still lose. Wimby was scoring and putting on the show, but they lost.
Yeah.
My thing is, let her shine. Let Angel Reese shine. And guess what's going to happen? When they shine, everybody else go shine.
But the old men, the pop that they get, the pub they get and stuff. Because Tarasi said before she came into the league, what time it was. You know, Tarasa, one of the greatest WNBA players of all time. So, but you're right, Dennis. I agree with every point you make.
And if you go back and look at whatever episode we were talking about Caitlin Clark, I said the same exact thing Unpredictable just said.
Let her shine.
But all y'all thought she's going to be a star. I told you she's going to be a bust.
I'm a fan of sports.
The pedestal we was trying to put her like she was Steph Curry, she couldn't. I knew she couldn't reach those standards.
Hey, I mean, still young. Well, I'm gonna say this. I remember Rihanna when she first came in the game. She was just. I remember the song she sung. I thought she was depressing. She kind of reminded me of Sade, like one of those depressing songs. But guess what happened when she came in? Beyonce took a back seat and didn't make an album. And guess what happened? It allowed Rihanna to shine. So guess what? Now Beyonce is still above Rihanna.
She is?
But, yeah.
Not money-wise.
Yeah.
No.
I don't know if I can say the other name. But I'm talking about as far as the celebrity status.
Oh, well, yeah.
So what happened was by Beyonce taking a step back just for a second, it allowed Rihanna to shine. Now, the agency, can we say Jay-Z on here? I don't know.
Paul.
No Jay-Z? All right. Now they were able to both shine, and now they're still shining no matter who has the most money. This one, she might be like, I got a billion. I got 1.2 billion. The WNBA needs to let these young ladies shine. They come in with the same thing with Bronny. If Bronny goes to a team that's not good, let him shine, because guess what? He has the followers. Let these people shine. You can still beat them. Wimby averaged 20 points, then win 20 games.
The sun can come out in an NBA game and Bronny still won't shine.
Oh, damn. I agree. But I just think that, hey, let her shine. Instead of making it hard for her, give her some space to shoot. Now, the last shot of the game, D her up. Just don't let her get it off. But because guess what they're going to say? Even if she missed the last shot, just like LeBron did when he had that wide open three against Denver, but they still talking about the four best player didn't score points. I don't know how he was up by 20. But if she missed the last shot, if she got 33 points, 7 rebounds, 7 assists, they're not going to talk about the last shot. They're going to talk about the 33 points she had. Make money.
Well, Angel Reese set an NBA record, a WNBA record. And ain't really a whole lot of people talking about that. Because they still want to make old girl the face of the league or whatever. But Angel Reese probably is going to be that one. But she still probably won't reach the heights of the projections they have for Caitlin Clark.
Yeah, it's pride. If we get on the podcast and they pay Gino the most, and if we all getting a million, he getting two, I'm not going to say nothing. You know why? Because I was in the school system making 50. So I guess what? I'm winning.
Yeah, you're right.
Now, if one day he don't make it to the show because something happened, somebody slipped something in his drink and he passed out, and I got to take over, I'm going to take advantage of that opportunity. But until then,
what Gino doing right now? He's not touching his nose.
Get off!
We need Caitlin to shine. I love the WNBA. I wanted to see it succeed, but we gotta let these youngsters shine.
WNBA, the Houston Comets. They won it 3 years in a row coming out the box, didn't they?
Yeah.
Swoop, and Cheryl it, Swoops, Cynthia.
And the
Cooper.
Money went down every year. Hey, I'll be the first one to say it. I used to go to the games. I support them. I like the way they play. But I heard somebody say, well, they don't want to get paid like the NBA players. They want the revenue sharing percentage like the NBA players. I'm all fine with that. Now, this is just me on the outside looking in. Unless the books are cooked, how can you get – if let's just say, hey, I'm right now, I'm on the record. The WNBA players should get 50% of the revenue sharing. If not, something is wrong. Now, here's the problem. The WNBA has lost an average of $10 million. There's no revenue sharing because they're losing.
Facts.
You can't get – so at the end of the day, let them shine. Just DM up on the last play.
Everybody can't be LeBron's son.
The math ain't mathing.
Get a huge NIL.
A man in love with Bronny, boy. I agree. I tell you.
I'm not.
I know what I'm getting you for Father's Day. Brace yourself.
I'm just saying, I was speaking on the unfair. I mean, some people got to do stuff to get stuff. Some people don't. Shout out to Shadur Sanders, man, making the cover of
now you want to give him
College Football 25, EA College Football 25. Go check out the it's on our YouTube. I mean, on our Facebook page. Go check out the trailer. I don't think this is the right group to talk about the new game with.
So yeah, I guess please don't wait till
next week. We might have my boy People Champ in the building next week.
Why we didn't have no video this week, sir? The people gonna be asking the question why we ain't got no videos. What you gonna tell them?
Oh, Joe voted down the videos for this week. I just got back off 8 to 5, so oh, okay. we didn't have any videos this week, but we did have a formative show, and we are going to catch this next game 7 because people in New York is just, I mean,
what's the final score?
It's 130-107.
Oh my goodness, them gonna bust 130 in a playoff game.
Yeah, they scored the most points in the first three quarters since the Celtics in 63 or something like that.
So, y'all get ready for that snooze fest next week. I just said next week because it should be a sweep. Everybody going to have their attention on in the West because you're going to have great white hype against the Serbian and all those people that didn't go to college. You had them playing against each other next week.
You're gonna be a hater all your life, man.
Stop. Joker and Luca. You had a Joker and Luca fest next week. Listen, man, do something tonight. But the Celtics and the Pacers will be a boring contest. But one person did get on here and say that
Indiana Pacers are a dark horse.
Yeah, they dark, all right. But one, it's boring. One person, when we did pick the finals, one person did get on here and say the Nuggets and the Celtics. Yes. The Nuggets had to win tonight. I hope they don't. I think Joe had mentioned a question. What does that mean if the Nuggets three-peat?
No. Two-peat.
I mean, repeat. Yeah, that was double the Chiefs two-peat. So that's the last question we got before we're going to get on up out of here. What does that mean if the Nuggets repeat? Clutch. Clutch. What you got?
Yeah, go ahead, Clutch.
Nuggets repeat.
To me, it don't mean anything. I mean,
boy, that man said don't mean anything. Great.
Now, leave it right there. Sometime, doesn't have to be explained. It's a Wayne quote, but it's unpredictable. What does it mean if the Nuggets repeat?
To me, I think it shows how, honestly, how competitive the 90s were when they talk about superstars and Hall of Famers and who didn't have this and who didn't have that. You know, and let's say the Joker is the Joker. And one thing I love about the Joker, I was on that Kendrick Perkins hype when he said he was go get it only because he was white, until he came on a big stage in the playoffs against the Twin Towers in Minnesota, against DeAndre Ayton, who's an athlete, against AD for the Lakers and Bam for Miami. That's probably five of the top seven big men in the league, minus Embiid and Giannis, and he dominated. So to say you got a team that's built like the 90s, one great big center, and four of the people who go come in and do their job who never make an all-star, that goes to show you you can have a team for the Hall of Famers, but you got to play. So to me, they remind me of the they're a little bit better, but they remind me of the Houston Rockets, those years that they actually won the NBA Finals. You had Akeem, and then you kind of stepped in that second year with Clyde, maybe Kenny Smith, but it goes to show you, you don't have to have Hall of Famers and superstars to be downgraded as a champ. And they just proven you don't have to have a team full of superstars.
Thanks. I think the NBA is broken if they go back to back. And man, the NBA needs to be fixed.
Why
not fixed as in, because it's just it's trash. If that team goes back to back. And that man had 3 out of 4 MVPs. And that team goes back to back. The NBA is broken and needs a savior. Go, Trigger Man Joe. What does it mean?
I wish I understood what you said.
It's broke. That the league is broke. If the Nuggets win back to back, something's wrong with the league.
So you said, can I ask him a question?
Hey, I got 2 minutes left. Joe, do you want to?
Okay. Boston has repeated as champion. The Lakers have repeated as champion. Detroit Pistons, Houston Rockets. If you repeat in this league, you would be considered great. And they started this series off 2-0 at home in the negative, 0-2 or whatever I want to put. So they had like a 6% chance of winning this series. Now they got game 7 at home, so I don't want them to win because I pick Minnesota, and I like Minnesota anyway. But if they was to go home and achieve double-double, they got to be put on the list, man. And the Joker done won 3 out of the last 4 MVPs. The GM, would you prove like you could add players? Sim said you add players to your teams who's not Hall of Famer. They added the dunk dude from Orlando. I don't know why I'm forgetting his name.
Aaron Gordon
played on a movie too. But it's those chess moves you make as a GM in the NBA to put you over the top. Even the Dallas Mavericks by getting Kyrie, and everybody said that was a D-minus trade, and they picked up P.J. Washington, and they picked up the Daniel Gafford, the center from the Washington, Washington Wizards. That's their last name.
And they didn't give up a lot to get him.
Let him talk, man. Two minutes, man.
Flowers, man. You talking about it's broken. It ain't broken. The Joker that make them look like they broke.
Hey, let us know
when
in the Facebook.
Something they don't understand. We want to try to cheapen it. It's great.
Hey, Gina, before we go, who's broke about it?
Hour and 45
minutes.
That's
what I'm saying. He don't make no sense. He light skinned. It ain't got to make sense when you're light skinned. You put anything in the atmosphere, they believe it.
Right.
The
world
watch on the podcast and the notes, they're going to be co-signing with him.
Mile later, Carla.
You got to go.
Friday. You won't even be doing the podcast.
Can I say, hey, how much time we got left? I just want to say,
Gino, let him come back.
Here we go. Mike Malone did not have a winning season the first 3 years, and they stuck with him every year, and the Joker. And when Murray was supposed to, he thought he was going to get traded because he was hurt. The coach said, we are in it to win it. So when we talk about great coaches, I keep saying this. I'm not saying Darvin Ham was great or not. After 2 years, you just can't say he's not great. You got rid of him. To build a team in chemistry, it takes time. You don't get married the first day you meet him. You date him, and you find out about him. You realize the chemistry takes time.
Progress is a process.
I love it, especially when LeBron lost.
Well, let us know in the chat, man. Hey, subscribe to the page.
Get your line up. Get your weight up.
Episode 10. Subscribe, share, like, comment. If you don't think I know what I'm talking about, let me know. If you don't think Trigger Man Joe, please let him know. Because y'all already let Unpredictable know.
You see the old
and guess what? Unpredictable don't run from that smoke.
Where the young heads at?
I don't know.
How we outlasting the young heads?
I don't know, but it's a couple guests won't come on.
That's the generation living in.
Guess what? Tell them come on. We can bring the smoke. I'm like Stephen A. Man, come on.
That man said he already froze to you in the comments, but I'm going to let him
come. And I came right back at him. I said, your homeboy sell used cars. I know you ain't got no life.
All right, man. Hey, another great show, but please.
no quote this week, man.
Yes, Clutch is quoting. Clutch is here with his quote every week. You waiting on them bets and stuff? I don't know. Tell the man, text me or something. I don't know. I don't know.
Bet the Pacers go over 130 today.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to change it to Sims post bets. Yeah, he's going to tell you.
Hey, you didn't ask me to win.
Yeah. What you got, Clutch?
All right, Clutch's quote of the week this week is, success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It's the courage to continue that counts.
Indeed. Continue.
Hey, can I get one?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, here we go. Hey, there's nothing wrong with being proud of your family, and there's nothing wrong with being successful through nepotism until you get pimped out by your daddy. We'll be right back.